This video is a little heavy. It's a little heavy in that it is really a heart-to-heart conversation that I am having with someone who replied to a comment that I made on another person's video. So let me explain. A few days ago, I think it was last week, I was looking at a video, a YouTube video. There was a nurse who was explaining why she had left her high-paying nursing job. And I hear that's going on in the nursing industry. I don't know for sure. I'm not a nurse, but I'm hearing that it's going on. Nurses are leaving the profession. Teachers are leaving. A lot of people are leaving the profession. Yeah, and I'm sure many of you have heard of the Great Resignation. But anyway, this nurse was explaining how she was being micromanaged and how she felt and how her she was being sabotaged, basically. So she ended her assignment, and it was a high-paying assignment. I'm not going to get into details about the video. I will link the video in the description box below. You can look at it. You can probably also see my comment. But anyway, in my comment, I kind of explained that this micromanagement and sabotage, it's everywhere, and not just in the nursing industry. And somebody responded to me. She replied to my comment. And this is who I'm making this video for, to her and women like her. Basically, the individual that responded, she indicated that she felt like going into the bathroom crying every single day. She had just gotten promoted to supervision, I think less than a year ago. It'd be almost a year. I think that's what her response said. And she's yelled at every day. She wasn't properly trained for her position. And when she asks for help, she doesn't get help. Other people are not treated the way she's treated. She feels disrespected, and she feels like she's being set up on her job for failure. She also indicated in her reply that she was having anxiety, and she and her blood pressure was going up. Now, for me, if I'm honest, the per type of person I am, I'm always concerned about other people. I just wanted to say, email me, email me, because I knew what she was going through. But there are certain things you can't do on YouTube without jeopardizing my channel. But this video is for that person and people who are like her. One of the interesting things that I noticed about this particular video is it's an older video. I think it's like 2 months old, but there are over 700 comments. The last time I looked, there was over 700 and like 22 comments. And all of these people, most of these people were experiencing a lot of workplace hostility. They worked in different industries. Some were teachers, some were nurses, some worked in government like myself, some were in supervision. So hence my video. Again, I will link the video that I'm referring to in the description below. So if you're interested in looking at it, I'll put that there for you. And like I said, there was so many comments, and there were over 100 likes to my comment, and I had only put it up there a few days ago. I don't know what it is now, but people were liking it. And I'm not saying that to say, oh, they like what I said. I'm saying that because it resonated with a lot of people, and it is a problem. This toxic work environment, this harassment, this toxic workplace situation, it is a real problem, and Black women are suffering because of it. I'm not saying that others aren't suffering, but my channel is addressed to Black women. So, some of you who have been with me since the beginning, since I started the YouTube channel in April, may recall that I shared my own experiences as being a target of workplace bullying and racial discrimination, blackballing, career sabotage. And it's in my first video. I will also link that somewhere up, and then also I'll put it in the description below. But I shared that, and I'm not going to get into all of the details of what happened to me. And I'm not a victim. You know, I'm not a victim. I don't consider myself a victim, but I was a target. And there's a difference. Okay. I was a target, and reading many of the responses in that prior video, and just talking to people over and over, Black women, they're experiencing this targeting, and it's crazy. It is insane. So, you know, I want to just talk a little bit about that now. And while I was able to resign from my toxic job via retirement, I completely recognize that everybody is not able to do that. Not everybody's able to leave. So in line with supporting other sisters, and that's a not an ER, you know, Black women, in line with supporting them, I wanted to share some resources that may be helpful for Black women who have decided to leave a toxic work environment. Okay. Now, before I get started, I just want to clarify, okay, that I am not telling anyone to quit their toxic job. Okay. Nor am I encouraging anyone to stay in a toxic workplace. Okay. The decision to say goodbye to a toxic, job is a personal decision. Only you can answer the question, should I leave a toxic workplace for yourself? I can't do it for you, okay? Nor will I. However, if you decide to leave a toxic job, here are five resources that I think may be helpful for you as you create your exit plan. You know, I think it may be helpful for you to look at some of these resources. Check them out. I don't guarantee anything. I am just sharing information. So for those of you who don't know who I am, hi sis, my name is Colette. I created this channel as a safe space with you in mind. I help Black women to embrace new seasons in their lives with purpose and with joy by pursuing resilience, practicing self-leadership, and pivoting towards entrepreneurship. If anything I said resonates with you, please join the community. We'd be happy to have you. Now, at this time, I'd like to encourage everyone to grab a piece of paper or a pen, to take some notes, get comfortable, and we're going to talk. You'll see me looking down because I have a lot of notes, and I'm going to go ahead and be referring to those because I don't want to forget anything. Also, if you are not able to write down the names of all of the resources that I'm going to provide, no worries. I will link the video. I will put the links to these resources in the description box below. I'm going to plug my laptop in real quick because I forgot to do that and it may go out. Okay, so these resources are in no particular order. I just wanted to share them with you just in case you are a Black woman and you have decided to leave your toxic work environment. So resource number one is a person named Libria Jones. Libria has been working remotely for over a decade, okay? On her YouTube channel, she provides valuable job search information. She provides information about how to look for remote work. She provides tools and tips on how to search for those jobs, how to apply for those jobs. It's very valuable. If you are a person who want to leave your top current toxic work environment and you can't afford to like just quit and not work at all, like you don't have retirement, you don't have savings, what have you, no worries. If you want a job remotely, check out her channel. It's Liberia Jones. She is also active on Instagram. Her name is spelled Liberia Jones. And again, I'll provide a link to her YouTube channel in the description box below. So that's resource number one, how to find remote jobs. Resource number two, her name is Anne Marie. Anne Marie is an HR consultant. She has a YouTube channel called Bald Girl Will Travel. Yes, bald, like bald, B-A-L-D, girl will travel. And she helps individuals to, she deals with helping her clients to deal with and create a hostile work environment escape strategy. She also has a hostile work environment escape strategy documentation journal that helps you to document the things that are happening to you. In addition to that, she offers a hostile work environment escape strategy webinar series. It's amazing. In fact, on her YouTube channel, she has a video called something about documentation, about how to document things. And I will link that, I'll put a link to that specific video also in my description box. So if you wanna work on a plan, Anne Marie's channel is called Bald Girl Will Travel. She's awesome and she knows her stuff, okay? Number three, if you need to work on getting your finances together, there is another resource that channel is called Picky Girl Travels the World. Now, what Adelia does is she helps Black women to get their finances in order to do what they want to do in their lives. And again, her channel, her YouTube channel is called Picky Girl Travels the World. And that's Picky, P-I-K-Y, Girl Travels the World. She also has a podcast. Very, 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 very knowledgeable. She currently lives in Mexico City, I believe, but off the chain. The other person, Anne Marie, she lives, I think, in Merida, Mexico. So some of these people that I'll be referring you to, they live in other countries, but they were originally from the U.S. And I'll link her information in the description box below as well. So I've given you three so far. So the fourth one is Rashida Dow. Now, Rashida Dow has a YouTube channel called Shida's on the Loose, and that's S-H-I-D-A apostrophe S on the Loose. Rashida lives, and we call her Shida, lives in Mexico City, and her channel, she's an attorney, or was an attorney. She is an attorney, actually. I don't think she's practicing. She is a career break and sabbatical coach to Black women. So some of you may say, Colette, listen, I can't retire, but I just need a break. What Rashida does is she helps you to map out a way to where you can take a career break or sabbatical. Some people call it a gap year, a grown-up gap year. Some people do that. She helps you to do that. Now, I am in her coaching program, amazing program. It's called From Burnout to Bliss Coaching Program. And it has changed my life completely, 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 completely changed my life. Being in the program helped me to leave a very hostile, toxic, and harmful work environment. And basically, we attend meetings every month and we get to be around other Black women who are just encouraging and just so supportive and helpful to you, you know. And she has there's a private Facebook page too. And you have to be a Black woman to be in it. That's what I like. I like that I'm able to be around women who look like me, who experience some of the same situations that I experienced due to being a member of two marginalized communities, one of being Black and two of being a female. So that has been very helpful for me. I am not here to promote and to tell you or to sell anybody's programs or anything like that. I'm not even getting paid for it. I don't expect anything. I am just sharing some of the resources and some of the things that I use as a part of my support system, because I think it's very important for us as Black women to share information with one another. I really, really believe in that. I did a video about how Black women can support one another. I will link that up somewhere. It appears somewhere as well. It's very, very important. If you have information that you think can help another Black woman, help her. Help her. And if you are not the type of Black woman that want to help other Black women, this is not the channel for you. Okay? I'm going to just be blunt. It's not the channel for you. Okay? So I've shared four resources with you. The fifth one, and I call her the GOAT, is Stephanie Perry. Stephanie, I stumbled across her channel last year, I think it was. And it was not, I could say it was a coincidence or accident. It wasn't. I don't believe it was an accident. I believe it was God sent. And what Stephanie does is she teaches Black women how to embrace ease and to take a career break as well, and a sabbatical. She calls it a grown-up gap year as well. In fact, Stephanie and Rashida Dow, the one I just mentioned, they're partners in an organization called the Exodus Summit, and it's Exodus with a U.S. capitalized summit. And Exodus Summit is a group of women all over the world that give this summit, and Black women from all over the world attend. I attended last year's summit, changed my life. I can't even talk about how much it changed my life. It was a virtual summit, like I said, of Black women from all over the world, and it was amazing. And it's something to see other people who, one, have gone through what you've gone through, two, have overcome that, made changes and got out of that situation, escaped the violence. And it is violence. Toxic work environments are violent, okay? And so, and that are, three, willing to share how they escaped these situations. Many of them not only left toxic work environments, they actually left the States. They don't live here. Some of them do. Some of them don't. Some of them are nomadic. They travel to different countries. You may not be able to do that, but the information provided is very helpful. In fact, I was supposed to be in Cancun, Mexico with the Exodus Summit for an Exodus Summit meetup right now, today, actually. I had booked my everything. I was supposed to go, but I ended up having to cancel. So Stephanie, Rashida, and Exodus Summit ladies, you guys have a great time. I miss you. I'll catch you next year. Okay. So, in fact, this is how I met or became familiar with all of the resources that I have shared with you. You know, is through the Exodus Summit. Okay. So, Stephanie also, getting back to her, she also she helps women. Black women to start a YouTube channel. I actually joined her YouTube success challenge. She's a YouTube success coach. And that's how I started my little channel, you know. So she's my YouTube success coach. I think I've shared with you before. I believe in coaches. I believe in accountability. I believe in therapists. I believe in community. So she's part of my support system. Okay. I will link Stephanie's I'll put a link to Stephanie's YouTube channel below, and then I will also put a link to the Exodus Summit private Facebook page in the description box. Now, I'm going to just remind you again, you have to be a Black woman to be in the Exodus Summit Facebook private Facebook group. That is what it is. And if you don't have a picture on your Facebook account, you won't be, they won't accept you. You'll be declined. I had actually left Facebook for a couple years and actually reopened my account just to be a part of this private Facebook group. And so, you know, I just wanted to share that, okay? So those were five resources for Black women ready to leave toxic jobs. Listen, I know that I just want you to know, and this is for, like I said, the lady in the response. I mean, my heart goes out to her, you know. I just want her and others like her and you to know you're not stuck. You know, you have choices. You have some planning that you may need to do. You have choices. You deserve to be treated with respect and dignity on your job. Now, I'm not going to sit here and lie to you and tell you that it's easy, you know. But as my YouTube success coach, Stephanie Perry, always says, you know, you're already living your worst case scenario. You're already living that. You're living your worst case scenario right now, okay? Before I go, I want to draw some attention to my little poster right here. Let's see if I can do my hand right. That, you may notice, is Harriet Tubman, okay? I thought it fitting, being that we just left Juneteenth this past month, and now we're moving into the so-called Independence Day weekend here in the U.S., you know? Harriet led people to freedom, okay? That's what she did. She created a path. She created a strategy for enslaved Black people, okay, to become free, right? But they had to choose liberty for themselves to get there. What does that mean, Colette? That means that it was not going to be easy. Leaving a plantation, which many of us are still working on, if you are working in a toxic workplace, a toxic, abusive, harmful workplace, it's a plantation, okay? And it was hard. People had to make hard decisions. Some of them had to leave their families who didn't want to go or couldn't go. Some of them had to leave them knowing that they may never see them again, okay? It was hard. Some of them had to leave knowing that they may be captured. You may say, Claire, well, what does that have to do with me leaving a toxic work environment? It has to do with you making a decision that you don't want to be abused anymore, that you do not want to be treated disrespectfully anymore. It's a decision, the decision that they made, our ancestors made, that Harriet Tubman offered freedom for, the decision that they made, you have to make that same decision for yourself. I can't make it for you. No one else can make it for you. And I'm not going to push you and tell you what you should do. You have to look inside yourself and determine what is freedom worth for you? What is liberty worth? What is your life worth? Okay. And I'm not just saying that. I shared in my first video, I had heart palpitations. I had to have the ambulance called a number of times, okay, due to my blood pressure shooting up to the point where they thought I was going to have a stroke. Work. And the job not hard. Job not hard. Job was not hard. Just the harassment, okay? The bullying, the microaggressions, the micromanagement. I've seen it and been through it all, okay? And I was in management, in a good government job, okay? And to be honest with you, HR is not there for you. They're not. They don't have your back. They're there for that organization and that company. And I spoke about Anne Marie has a video on that HR is not for you. She worked in HR, okay? They're not there for you, okay? So you have to be your own ally. You have to decide, okay, I cannot take this. I can take that. And when you decide, those resources that I listed may be helpful. You may consider working on those resources or looking at those resources while you're dealing with the situation that you're dealing with, because you may not be able to leave right away. Okay. And so I just wanted to share that with you. I wanted to say good luck, sis, and God bless you. And I pray that you make a decision that is going to be helpful for you, not anybody else, but for you. And I understand that you have responsibilities and things you have to consider. So consider them. Move wisely, but move quietly. Okay. In closing, what I'd like to say is it's different. It's different. When you leave such a hostile, stressful working environment, your life is different. Okay. It's different. It is. Now, I'm not going to lie to you. I got people at the job who look at the channel. They let me know. Don't care. Hi. Okay. I am here to help Black women not stay in a toxic work environment 1 second longer than they need to. Because I'm going to just say it like this. All money ain't good money. And I'm going to end here. If you enjoyed this video, and I know it was hard, I know it was tough, and this is actually a series that I'm going to be doing. It's called Black Women Get Out. Yes, that's the name of the series. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, like it, and share it with anybody who you think may find it useful. It really helps the YouTube algorithm in suggesting the videos to others who may need to see this information. If you're not somebody who finds it useful, it's okay. No worries. No harm, no foul. If you would like to see more content, like you want to see the series that I'm coming up with, and it's going to be through the whole entire month of July, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Make sure when you subscribe to hit the notification bell so that you are notified whenever I upload a new video. My goal, you guys, is to post these videos at least once or twice a week. I'm trying to do it on Tuesdays and Thursdays, but I'm playing around with the dates. Okay. If you have suggestions about future videos, or you just have comments about this video, leave them in the comments field. I read all the comments. And if you have some suggestions or some resources that may be helpful for Black women who have decided to leave a toxic work environment, please put those in the comments. Now, I do want to give a disclaimer. I don't guarantee anything. I shared the suggestions as a way to educate and inform, and I don't endorse anyone. I can say that I've used the services of some of the people who I've listed. That I've named. So again, I will put all of their information in the description below. Eventually, when I figure out how to do subtitles, I'll put subtitles on things. But until we talk again, take care and have a great day. And remember Harriet over here. She can try to lead you, but you got to decide you want to go.